Very good morning. So today we are going to discuss about the matter related to seed production cotton. As far as that cotton is concerned, this crop have both variety and hybrid. So before getting into that seed production aspects, I wanted to give you some informations about that seed and its internal structures. That internal structure of that seed is concerned here, that the cotyledon is arranged just like a folded, so it's a folded cotyledon. Whatever you are seeing here, that is a cotyledon. So in the original seeds, it's a line diagram, whereas in the original seeds you can see the cotyledon is folded and put it inside the seeds, and white color solid things also available at the base, so that is a radical part. After that, the entire thing will be surrounded by one white color covering. Then just above that white color covering, that whatever you are seeing from the externally, that is a brown color one, that seed coat will be there. So totally this have two coverings, and then over that only that lint will be there. So that is a fibrous matter. So this is a structure of this one. So this also comes under that ticotyledon category and folded cotyledon group. So similar kind of structures also available in the case of bendy also. In bendy also we can discuss that same thing. So regarding that floral biology, so the simple flowers, the bigger size flowers and axillary and the petals are initially yellow in color, and nectary glands will be available on inner side of the flowers. We can see some brown or red color glands will be available, and the calyx are 5 in number, united cup shaped corolla, a 5 number of corolla and cup shaped one, and androecium forming, and that is a staminal column. So here you can see this is a staminal column, and that staminal column that surround that style and stigma is completely surrounded by the that stigma column. Normally in the case of cotton, the style will be arranged like this, the tip, that stigma will be available. Surrounding this, in the base, that ovary will be available. Surrounding this, that staminal column will be available. So in between this, in between that staminal column and style, that is empty space. The another thing is, the base of the staminal column is attached with the yellow color petal. So attached with the yellow color petal, this is like that, this is arranged like that. So this is much useful for us for doing that emasculation. So just to you remove that petals, automatically the staminal column also come along with the petals. So that is a easy job with reference to emasculation of that cotton flower is concerned. So the ovary are superior nature and pentacarpillary, and the styles are slender and pass through the staminal column with the 3 to 5 lobed stigmas. Ovules may be many in axil plus undations. So this is a floral diagram that the cross section of the flowers. With reference to flower opening, some variations are recorded among the Asiatic cotton as well as an American cotton. In the case of Asiatic cotton, the flower opening will be in between 8 to 10 a.m. But in the American cotton, little bit earlier. So this and all influenced by the temperatures, and the receptivity of the stigma is 8 to 10 a.m. Cotton is comes under that often cross pollination category. So the chances for occurrence of the cross pollination is more than 60%. This is the overall view of that cotton life cycle. So that seeds will be sown, that germination, sprouting and seedling stage, and that reaches that plant. Then plant will produce that flowers. So that flower production, that conversion of the flower into a bolls and pole maturations. So these is these are all the important and critical stages as far as that cotton is concerned. So these are all the important and critical stages. So during that times we have to pay more attention, and we have to take care of the plants in order to get more fibers as well as the more seeds. Again, this is with reference to that flower development. So in detail, so here that initially the square will appear, and that the fibre pollinations, and that on the day of opening of the flower, that flower will be yellow in color. So on the day, in the once the pollination is effective, and the same day that will become somewhat pink in color. So on the day of on the night or in the evening time, that will become a deep red in color. So this color changes will happen during that and this is time. So once that pollination is effective, that flower will be converted into bowls. So as and when that bowl attain maturity, hairline crack will occur and the complete burst opening of the kapas will be there. So the completely opened kapas alone we have to collect for the seed purpose. So here that duration for appearance of that different stages also mentioned here. So another thing with reference to that cotton is concerned, so here two type of branching normally occur. One is a symbodial branching, another one is a monopodial branching. Symbodial branching only that flower and pole production will be there, that is a reproductive branching, whereas that a symbodial vegetative that is at a vegetative branching or a monopodial branching, that is a vegetative one. Okay, there we cannot have any that bowls and all. So clearly given in this line diagram. So this is a monopodial branching, this able to produce only that leaf alone, it's a vegetative nature, whereas that is symbodial branching only we can harvest that fruits and everything will be available. So two type of branching as far as that cotton is concerned. So right now we have four different species for cultivations. So those species are Gossypium arboreum and Gossypium herbaceum and Gossypium hirsutum and Gossypium barbadans. Among the four species, that Gossypium hirsutum that occupy that major area, more than 90% of the cotton growing area is occupied by the Gossypium hirsutum type. Now all the four cases we have some varieties also, particularly in the case of Gossypium arboreum, that example for that variety comes in that particular species is K10. Herbaceum, Uppam, the variety Uppam, and Hirsutum, all the MCU varieties, all the MCU series that will come under that Hirsutum type. And Barbadans, that Suina and Suguna, particularly the Barbadans used as a male parental line during that hybrid seed production program. Mainly these metals used as a male parent during that hybridization development programs. So here you can see that differences in leaf structures with reference to that Gossypium arboreum and hirsutums, and here also you can see that diagrams. So that is that Gossypium differences and all clearly given here. Similarly here that Gossypium barbadans and hirsutum, that leaf and their differences. Similarly the another slides you can see that flower color variations and plant stature variations and all among the Hirsutum, Barbadans, Herbaceum and Arboreum. Regarding that history of that history or breeding aspects of that cotton in India is concerned, so we are the pioneer with reference to hybrid cotton work is concerned, and also we are the one first released that hybrid also for commercial cultivations. The person responsible for development of the first hybrid is Chandrakant T. Patel, in short called as C.T. Patel. Actually he is a scientist, worked at Surat Palm, Gujarat. So that comes under the Surat Agriculture University. So he developed a hybrid, that hybrid is named as Hybrid 4, in short called as H4, or otherwise called as a Sangar 4, that is released for commercial cultivation during 1970. Because of that, Chandrakant T. Patel, very popularly known as father of hybrid cotton, for development of that H4 cotton, he used that Gujarat 67 as a female parent, American Nectarilis as a female parent. Actually, it's a intra-specific hybrid. The variety is now known as a H4 cotton. So we are the pioneer. Indian is a pioneer with reference to hybrid cotton research is concerned. So I already told you that cotton have both variety and a hybrid. Again, that hybrid, we have a interspecific hybrid and intraspecific hybrid also. Some example for interspecific hybrids are Varalakshmi. It's actually it's a cross between the Hirsutum type and Barbadans type. TCH32 or otherwise known as Jayalakshmi. So this is a cross between again Hirsutum and Barbadans. And TCHP2 and 3, that also a hybrid. So that is a cross between again Gossypium and the Hirsutum and Barbadans. So that intraspecific one is a Savita. Savita is intraspecific. So these are all the things are available. So here two types of hybrids are available, interspecific and intraspecific hybrids, and varieties also available. So now we can discuss about that method of seed production with reference to that cotton variety. So generally that cotton varieties are subjected to seed production through controlled open pollination process. Hybrids are subjected to the emasculation testing process for hybrid seed production purpose. Regarding that land requirement, the selected land should not be cultivated with other variety of the same crop in the previous season, and ridges and furrows are formed for planting purpose. That most preferred soil is black cotton soil, highly preferable than other soil, and land should be free from wilted plants, that we have to ensure, and the selected land also should not have the problem of the wilt disease incident. Season for winter crops, August September is the best, but if it is before 15th of August means it's very good, and similarly for summer crop February March. Here also, if it is before 15th of February, that is the best season for varietal seed production. And normally seeds are directly sown, so manually we are sowing through tippling operations, so we have to use authenticated seed material. By that way we can avoid occurrence of the off-type plants in the seed production field. And then regarding that seed rate, here in the case of cotton, two type of materials are available: pussy seeds and delinted seeds. Pussy seeds mean the seed with leftover lints, so that here you can see that diagram and all. So this is a pussy seeds in the white color one and all, so pussy seeds, so the leftover the material will be there. If it is a pussy nature, that should be, we have to use 15 kg per hectare. If it is a delinted material, hardly we need as 1.5 kg per hectare alone. For a hybrid seed production, for male parent line, we need to have 2 kg per hectare, female parent line 4 kg per hectare. The F1 hybrid, distributed for commercial production means, in those cases we have to use 3.75 kg per hectare if it is a JLSME, and TCHP 213 1 kg per hectare. Then before sowing, the seed must be given with appropriate treatment. So here that very important treatment is acid delinting. If it is a pussy seeds, before sowing, that seed should be subjected to delinting. So the delinting process, what we are doing is, we have to take the pussy seeds in plastic buckets or a cement tank. So if you take 1 kg means in that you have to add 100 ml of commercial sulfuric acid. You have to add that one. After addition of that acid, we have to go for mixing of that bond. So you have to mix thoroughly and continuously for about 2 to 3 minutes. During mixing, whatever that acid is added, that will corrode that lint. So that will remove, that will digest the lint. Okay, as and when that seed become brown or black in color, at the time we have to stop that reactions by the way of addition of the water. Water also we should not pour directly into the bucket. In a sidewards we have to pour that one. So by that way you can avoid the occurrence of some acid and water hydration related accident and all. So slowly you have to pour from the sidewards. Then after addition of that water, you have to mix that seeds again clockwise and anti-clockwise. By that way you can ensure that removal of the excess acid that is available after this delinting process. So that is a thing. You have to do that washing several times, so 4 to 5 times. You have to ensure complete removal of that acids. So after removal, you will have the seed with black color seed coat, and that is totally divided up any that sponge matter, lint won't be there. So this is a very very important operations. The advantage of the delinting process is concerned, so during delinting process you are going to remove that sponge material left on the seeds. That sponge, that is a lint, the small lint that is available on the seed coat, it's serves a very good place for survival of the more number of the pathogen as well as the insect. So that is a conducive environment for survival of the pathogen as well as insects. So once that insect and pathogen going to be there in your seeds, that seed is used for sowing. During that seedling establishment itself, the seedling will have the problem of some diseases or insect infestations. Once you go for removal of the that lint that are available on the seeds through acid scarification, the acid will kill all the pathogen as well as insects that are surviving on the lint. So that is advantage. Apart from that, that the seeds, the through delinting process, we are going to remove all the lint. After removal, the seed will be fully visible, so you can go for that verification also, or grading is very easy, because in the case of cotton, the major problem is the occurrence of the ill-filled seeds. So all the seeds, both ill-filled seeds and fully nutrient packed seeds, appear to be similar in size and shape, but there will be a difference with reference to weight. So in order to separation of the ill-filled seeds from the filled seeds, you have to do that grading. So that is based on the weight. So one instrument is available, that is a specific gravity separator that will separate the seeds based on the weight. The only thing is, for separation of the seeds with the help of the specific gravity separator, we have to make our seeds somewhat free flowing nature, then only the separation is possible with the help of the specific gravity separator. So if the seeds going to be there along with the lint, it's a fussy nature, that is not a free flowing one, we cannot make that one as a free flowing. So in those cases, we cannot use that specific gravity separator for separation purpose. But once your seed is delinted through that acid scarification process, and that singling will be there, the pus center removed, the seed will have a smooth seed coat, brown something. At the time, the seeds able to move freely. So that is the advantage of that delinting process. The only drawback with reference to that acid delinting process is concerned. Here we are going to use that acid, so that the duration of that acid treatment and the quantum of acid used for this treatment is very, very critical. If it is excess, so that may cause us problem to the viability of the seeds. The duration also exceed beyond that optimum level, there is a chance for that the seeds getting corroded. So these are all the drawback. So because of that, to carrying out these operations, we need a technical person, and the person doing that operation also must be very careful, or otherwise that causes some problem for the person involved in this operation. So this sort of thing, anyhow, that acid delinting is already proven technology. Many of the farmers also, they are following. Most of the private company also, they are following. Now some of the company, they are having another kind of setup, that is a dry gas delinting, and they are mixing that acids of that HCl and H2SO4. So on a particular compositions, they are, if you mix these two acids, that will produce that fumes, that produce a fumes, that fumes will be allowed to pass through that cotton seeds. So for doing this, the cotton seeds will be taken in a rotating cylinder. So the cotton seed, that cylinder will be in a continuous rotations, and the cylinder also placed in a horizontal manner. So from one end, that fumes will be allowed to enter into the cylinder. So that the fumes will interact with the seeds, and the fume will come out of the other end. So contact between that seeds and fumes, so whatever that lints are there, everything will be get corroded. So this also another way of treating that seeds for the purpose of removal of the lint. So very few company like Rossi Seeds have this particular setup. Then apart from that delinting process, we have to do that seed hardening operation also, because cotton is mostly sown under rainfed conditions, because it's a less water demanding crop and deep rooted crops. So if it is a rainfed sowing, we are recommending that a seed hardening treatment. So here also we have to follow that seed hardening treatment. So for this purpose, we have to use that potassium chloride. The percentage of the solution is 2%. Or we can use some plant extract also, particularly the plant extract, the extract of that prosopis juliflora, that have some alkaloids. That alkaloid make the plant to survive even under very harsh environment also. So through the seed hardening process, if you are able to infuse those alkaloids into the cotton seed system, means the cotton plants also will gain some drought tolerant mechanisms. Similarly, we can use that pungam leaf also for the purpose. So, but anyhow, Here that duration of soaking is 10 hours. The seed solution ratio is 1:1. So these are all some important pre-sowing treatment. Other than that, the regular biofertilizer treatment also here we have to follow. So here the recommended biofertilizer is Azoxystrobin. If it is through seed means, we have to use 3 pockets. If it is a soil applications, we have to use 10 pocket. So these are all the treatments with reference to that cotton seed is concerned. So this is a total delinting process. So once that lint is removed, the seed will be appear like this. The spacing for long duration, we have to follow 19 to 30 centimeter. For short duration, 15 to 30 centimeter. And for hybrids, so if it is a female parental line, there we have to maintain 120 into 60 centimeter. For male, 19 to 60 centimeter is recommended. Isolation distance, so here this comes under that often cross pollination category. So and the corolla also arranged like a cone shape, so possibility of entry of the parent pollen is very much restricted. Anyhow, so here the recommended isolation distance for foundation seed production, both for variety and hybrid, 50 meter, and for certified seed production it's a 30 meter. As far as the fertilizer is concerned, so this also a agriculture and a commercial crops. So here we are recommending 12.5 tons per hectare for manure, and NPK 60-30-30 kg of NPK per hectare. Out of this, 30 kg of nitrogen and 30 kg of phosphorus and 15 kg of potash applied as a basal, and remaining 50% of that nitrogen and potash applied as a top dressing on 40 to 45th day after sowing. So during 40 to 45th day after sowing, we will do earthing up operation like that of groundnut. So here the purpose of doing that earthing up operation is the giving a mechanical strength to the stem to stand erect to prevent the lodging, because the cotton going to have more number of the that symbodial branching. The symbodial branching is fully occupied with the bolts. So the branch with more number of bolts means that main stem need to be supported, or otherwise lodging will be there. Once that plant is lodged, all the bolts will have a direct contact with the soil. So if it is a soiled one, so there that fiber quality, everything will be not that much good. So we have to extend mechanical support for the stems. So for that purpose, we have to do the earthing up operation. So before earthing up operation, you can apply that 50% of that nitrogen and potash, then you can go for mixing of the soil, and you can do that earthing up operations. Then regarding that polio spray, so here we have to apply 2% DAP, and not one time, so 3 times we have to apply. That is 70 day after the sowing, 80 day after sowing, 19th day after sowing. So here we are recommending application of the DAP for 3 times. That is mainly because the cotton is a indeterminate type of flowering. So there will be a continuous flowering and continuous vegetative growth. So if you want to convert all the flowers into bowls with good quality seeds, we have to apply DAP in 3 times. That is the thing. The another major thing with reference to cotton is concerned, the boll shedding. Boll shedding and flower dropping is a major problem. You can see the diagram also. Here you can see. So whatever that flowers are produced by the cotton plants, that and all shed. So to retain all the flowers, to retain all the bolls in the plant itself, we have to apply 40 ppm naphthalene acetic acid on 40 to 45th day after sowing, and repeat that spray 15 days after the first spray. So this is mainly to prevent the boll shedding and flower dropping. So this is a very, very important operation as far as the cotton is concerned. Similar kind of applications we were also recommended for PGNB, because in the PGNB red gram, that flower shedding is a major problem. So there also we are recommending 40 ppm NAA. For preparation of 40 ppm, what we have to do is we have to dissolve 40 milligram in 1 liter of water. For acre, the spray fluid volume is 200 liter. Per hectare, the spray fluid volume is 500 liter. So accordingly you have to work out. So 40 milligram in 1 liter means you have to work out quantity of chemical needed for preparation of 200 liter. If it is a per acre, if it is a hectare, you have to work out what is the quantity of chemical needed for 500 liters. Accordingly, you have to prepare and apply. The important intercultural operation is concerns that weed control. So to control the weeds, like there are pulses here also, we are recommending that pentamethylene. So 650 ml per hectare, you have to apply as a pre-emergence. After that, we have to do that one hand weeding also, that is on 40 to 45th day after sowing. The netting up operation, I already told you. So to prevent the lodging of the plants, we have to do that netting up operations. Another important intercultural operation as far as that cotton is concerned, topping, that is nipping of that apical buds. So by that way only we can arrest the vegetative growth of the plant after certain stages. If you are going to allow that cotton to continue its vegetative growth, means a lot of energy may be wasted for vegetative growth alone. Okay, so whatever that bolls are developed initially, that also need of a photosynthetic material for the better development and better seed setting. So if pole development and vegetative growth going to happen on simultaneously, means there will be a problem with reference to that photosynthetic partitioning, photosynthetic material partitioning. So we have to, after certain stage of the growth and development, we have to arrest that apical growth. So ideal height of the plant is normally the plant with the 10 to 12 node stage. So as and when that plant attain 10 to 12 node stage, we have to do that nipping. Either you can do that nipping manually. Nipping means that removal of the apical bud, mainly towards the vertical growth. Either we can do it manually or we can apply malic acid for this purpose. So previously we discussed the application of malic acid in the case of groundnut. So that should be applied at the time that certain stages, mainly to prevent that viviparous germinations. Here we are applying that malic acids for the purpose of arresting that vegetative growth. So the terminal part will be killed by the malic acids. Then field standards, so for varieties, the maximum permissible haplotype limit in the case of foundation seed means 0.1%. For certified seeds, it's a 0.2%. For variety, parental line multiplication, that is foundation seed stage, that maximum permissible haplotype limit is 0.1%, and certified seed is 0.5%. Irrigation, once in 10 days we have to apply. The critical periods are pole formation to that pole maturity. So during that times, we must be ensure that availability of adequate moisture in the soil. And specific problems already we discussed, that is a pole shedding is a problem. So to overcome that particular problems, we are going to apply 40 ppm of NAA or psychosil, another growth regulator. So if it is psychosil, that should be applied the concentration of 20 ppm. So cotton is the main cause for more number of the insects. So insect causing a serious problem, that is a serious threatening factor. Particularly, a variety of bollworms are available. Bollworm, American bollworm, pink bollworm, spiny bollworm, spotted bollworm, like that. So many number of bollworms are there. All those bollworms, they eat only that bolls and its internal content. Both fiber as well as seed will be eaten away. As outcome of that, the farmer is not able to harvest any economically important product from the cotton. So here, that economically important part is, one is a fiber, another one is a seeds. So both the thing will be eaten away by the insects. So that is a major problems. So to control all those insects, the farmers during that crop growth period, they are in a position to apply minimum 20 number of insecticide spray. So 20 number of insecticide spray. Per spray, they are going to spend around 5,000 rupees. Mean, just imagine how much money they need to spend for the purpose of controlling the pest population alone. So if it is so, that cotton cultivation may not be a economically remunerative process. So that is a challenging one. In order to address this and in order to control that insect population, we have so many chemicals. Even though that chemicals are used for controlling, since that problem is prevailing, after knowing all these problems only, the biotechnology people, they develop a genetically modified material in the case of cotton, that is a PT cotton. That is a bacillus thuringiensis. It's a bacteria. From the bacteria, they isolated a gene called cry gene. So that grigene is incorporated in the cotton plants. The grigene that have the potential to produce that crystal protein. So the crystal proteins, if it is exposed to that pH of more than 14 at the time, that become a toxic one. So whenever that crystal proteins are exposed to the pH of more than 14 at the time, that will become a toxic. So that pH of alkaline pH and all prevailing only in the insect midgut, whereas in the human midgut and all the pH is somewhat acidic range. So if at all happen to consume, the human being, anybody happen to consume that bowls developed from the GMO, that won't cause us any problem because our pH and all acidic nature. But in the case of insect, that midgut, that pH is alkali range. So if at all that insect that eat that cryogen incorporated bowls, that bowl content will be entered into the midgut of the insects. So there that alkaline pH, due to alkaline pH, that will be converted into a toxic protein. The toxic protein will spoil the epithelial cells of the insects midgut. So once that epithelial cells are damaged, the insect not able to absorb the digested material. So because of that, and the insect will be die. So now this particular technology also very well accepted by the farmers. Now in India, most of the cotton growing area is occupied by the PT material. So by that way, we are managing that insect populations. So this is the thing. Apart from the bollworms, so here we have some problem of the white flies, and this and all some sucking pests, so they will transfer the virus. So here you can see that white flies. similarly the disease also, the wilt and root rot, that also causes problem. So to control that one, we have to use suitable biocontrol agents like Pseudomonas, Trichoderma, so Bacillus subtilis. So all those things we can apply. So by that way, we can control that disease also. So harvesting, so as and when that crop attain maturity, we have to harvest the thing. So here that matured bowls and all called as a kappas. So you have to harvest the fully opened kappas. Here you can see that image. So this is a fully opened kappas, so with the white color sponge. So that alone we have to collect for our seed purpose. So initially that will appear, hairline crack will be appear on the bowls. Then as and when that will be completely burst open, at the time we have to collect that bowls. So during that time, the moisture content will be 30 to 35%. So here I already told you, it's a indeterminate type of flowering behavior. So there will be a continuous pole development and the pole maturity. So for seed purpose, first 4 to 5 pickings alone we have to use for seed purpose, because that first 4 picking, whatever the poles we are going to collect, that and all early formed, that will be given with more amount of the photosynthetic materials. So the quality of the seed will be good. So if at all any bowls that have that hard lobules, so here this and all that individual lobules, and due to some pest and disease incidents, not able to open like that of the first image, not at all. That show the symptom of the pup. So if at all these kind of bowls or seeds are available, it's the brown colored one, or this kind of not opened, this and all normally known as a hard lobules. So this and all hard lobules. So these kind of materials are there. Those materials and all we should not include for seed extraction purpose. So for finding out the presence of all these, the harvested things, we have to do that kappa sorting operation. Through kappa sorting operations, we are going to remove all these material. So that is an important operations. So this is a various stages of the bowl development. So various stages. So as and when that attain maturity, hairline cracking, then that will first open. So for easy processing operations, I already told you, we have to convert that pussy seeds into delindered seeds through that acid scarification process. Then after that delindering process, we can do that separation based on the weight with the help of the specific gravity separator. So as far as that cotton is concerned, that seed standard says here we have to maintain physical purity of 98%, whereas the germination for variety is only 65%. So the lot having 65% of germinations, we can go for sale of that seed in the open market. If it is a variety, there we have to ensure 75% moisture content, I mean germinations. So these are all the items with reference to that cotton varietal seed production is concerned. So in the next segments, we can discuss about that hybrid seed production in cotton. Thank you very much.